Hello everybody, and welcome to another lecture on computer architecture. Today I'm going to talk to you about multiplication, how that is done in our computer. It's going to be a little bit complicated, but bear with me, it's going to be quite funny. The algorithm that is being used is called the Russian peasant algorithm, and in fact it's actually not doing so much multiplication as it is doing shift, mask and adding. Because multiplication is not mostly implemented in hardware. So let's take a look where we are. Let me put here an example of, first of all, of how do we do addition, humans, how do humans do addition, and then how the computer does addition in binary. We already know this, of course, because we have seen the full adder, things like this, and we have seen our ripple carry adder. So first I will go back to how humans are doing addition, then how the computer is doing addition, then how humans are doing multiplication, and then how the computer is doing multiplication, which is these two, they're called the Russian peasant algorithm. So let me take you here an example. Imagine I want to add 744. I want to add this to 888. Now my first operation is that I'm using here just two operands. Operand A is 888 and operand B is 744, because as we know, in a computer every operation is reduced to two operand operations. Always two operands input, one operand output. So I'm only going to reduce this, my calculations and my algorithm, to two operands. Humans sometimes can do various additions, three or four operands here, that's no problem. But no, the computer is doing only two. So every multi-operand operation is reduced to two operand operations. An example is given here. So I want to add 744 to 888. How do I do this? Well, I hope you all know how to do this. If not, maybe these lectures are not for you. So how do we do this? 8 plus 4, we know this. It is 2, well, it's 12, but we do this 2 and we remember a carry. So we put here a carry of 1. And then we do the addition, 8 plus 4 is again 12, but now we have a carry, so it is 1 extra, so it is 13. And then we have here 13, 3, with a carry of 1. 1 plus 8 is 9, plus 7 is 16. So we have here 6 with a carry of 1. And we have here, we can imagine this adds with 0, 0, 0, so we have, and the result is 1632. So what actually, what have I been doing? I've actually not even been doing any addition, I've been just memorizing this in hardware, in my hardware. This, in my head, I have, by primary school, I've been doing this so many times that I have more or less come up with this extensive table. Let me put a little bit here. So as an example, if I add 8 to 4, I have this in my head. 8, let me put this, is this one here, 8, that is operand A, and I add that to that 4, and that gives me 2 with a carry of 1. And in case the second one here is also 8 plus 4, but it has a carry. So I look in my table, 8 plus a carry, maybe the syntax here is a little bit strange, but this is 8 without carry, this is 8 plus carry, and then I look down here, 8 plus carry is 3, and it has a carry out. So this is actually what I'm doing. I'm constantly looking in my head for this table, and I know 8 plus 4 without thinking, actually it just comes up spontaneously in my hardware, it knows this, 8 plus 4 without the carry is 2 with the carry out. 8 plus 4 with a carry is 3 with a carry out. And then, of course, what did I do? I started with just two digits. And then the next digit, I sort of do this ripple carry adding, which we all know. So basically what I'm doing, I'm adding two digits. Then maybe there's a carry in or not. And then it produces a carry out or not, and I again do an addition. And this hardware here, it looks as if there are six different hardwares, but in fact it is done with one hardware. As we see in the computer, then it is done with six different hardware sets, circuits, but in our head we use the same hardware to do this operation. So what we have here, we have an adder, that is basically the implementation of this table, and then it has two input digits, A and B, with or without a carry, and it produces the sum of the two digits plus a carry. The sum is always between 0 and 9, and the carry then is at best, note, very careful, look here in the table, the carry is at most is 1. It's either 0 or 1, and this is caused by the fact that we are just doing two operands. And with two operands, 9 plus 9 plus the carry is actually 9, and with the carry is the output. So the carry is at best, at most, is 1. So this is an important observation. Now let me then go how this is done then in binary. Well, this actually we already know. We have already done in the lectures before. We have this table, which is the equivalent of this table in decimal. It's this table in binary. And we know this circuit already because that is the full adder. As we remember, now I have to get a little bit messy, but we have this thing for decimal, we call it just simply an adder, but for binary, this was the full adder. And then we could do the binary, we could link them together to make the ripple carry adder. Once again, remember, we started this chapter on integration about our computing. We started with constructing the full adder, which had this truth table for the sum and for the carry. Coming in was the bit B, operand B, operand A, and possibly the carry. Three inputs, two outputs. Remember, it's a full adder. And then we linked them together to make a ripple carry adder. So what we were doing, we could do now a multi-bit sum. And then we continue here. Now, let's do, how do we do, let me close this one. And this one to not mess it up too much. How do we do multiplications? Well, how do humans do multiplications? Let me put here again an example. 2, 3, 8. I have 2, 3, 8. And I want to multiply it by 1, 2, 3. Well, this 1 and 2, I will just for the moment, remember, I will forget for the moment. This is how we do it. We forget, we only look at the last digit. And then I do the multiplication. Well, 3 times 8. That is 4 with a carry of 2. Remember, now the carries can be larger than 1. 3 times 3 is 9. Just have this in memory. Plus 2 is 11, plus a carry. 3 times 2 is 6, plus 1 is 7, and there is no carry. So we finished our calculation. We have done now the first bit. The first digit, the entire first operand multiplied by the least significant digit of the second operand. So I need a table that is doing exactly that. I want a table that is doing one operand, 3, times the other operand, 8. So I have it here. 3 times 8 is 4 with 2 carries. 4 with 2 carries. Or I can do here if you want. 3 times 8 is 4 plus 2 carries. 3 times 8 is 4 plus 2 carries. And then I do this the same. 3 times 3. 3 times 3 is 9 without the carry, but we still have 2 carries. So we're also doing summing and we come up with this number. And now comes the trick. This is why it's called the Russian peasant algorithm. Remember that we have this table we have in our head. But what am I going to do now? I'm going to shift this digit, this operand to the left, multiplying it by the base, which is adding a 0 at the right, and this one I will divide by 10, by the base, so to skip, to remove this last digit. So what do we get now? We have to remember this one, actually, this value we have to remember somewhere, and now I will shift this one to the left and this one to the right. So what do we get? 2, 3, 8, 0. And I have to multiply it by, well, I will forget, for a moment, I will forget the 1. And I will just only do the multiplication by 2. Multiply. That is easy, because I have the table for that. 2 times 0 is 0. No carry. 2 times 8 is 6. Plus a carry. 2 times 3 is 6. Plus a carry, it's 7. I hope I'm doing my calculations correct, that I'm not making a mistake here in front of the camera. No carry. And 2 times 2 is 4, without a carry is 4. That's nice. So what am I going to do now? I'm going to add this one to this one, but I want to speed up this video a little bit, so I will do this only at the end, and I will hope that you already now by now get it. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to shift this one again to the left and this one to the right to do the final operation. So I get 2, 3, 8, 0, 0 times, well, this one is removed and the only remaining is 1. That multiplication, of course, is very simple. That is 0, 0, 8, 3, 2. That multiplication table is quite simple. So now I'm going to add this together. This result to this result to this result, which is 714 4760 2 3 8 0 0, and I will add them all together. Of course, the computer would do it in 2 steps. But the humans can do it in 3 steps, and I don't want to make a mistake, so I'll just copy it here from my copy book here, and that is 29,274. The trick is that we're doing, actually we learned it, but without realizing it, that we're shifting the A operand to the left and the B operand to the right. And then we get this kind of result. So why not do this exactly the same for binary? Once again, this is our decimal table, and as you will see here in binary, it is much simpler because the multiplication table that we need is actually simply this one. It is actually simply an AND. And 0 times 0 is 0, 0 times 1 is 0, 0 times 1, 1 times 0 is 0, and only 1 times 1 is 1. And note, there is never any carry. We do not have to take care of the carries. So the only thing we have to do is shifting and adding, never anything with carries. Let me give you once again, let me give you here an example, and then maybe you will get it. I store here, I have one, or at least can start thinking about storing it in registers, so that I will call a result. That is this one here, result. It starts with a 0. And now I start with the A operand. Let's say it's 10, which is in binary 1010. And the B operand is 5, which is 101, as we all know. So what am I going to do? I'm going to actually, in this case, I'm going to go back to black. I'm going to look at only the last digit, like with our decimal multiplications, I'm only want the last digit. So what am I going to do? I'm going to look at B and I'm going to AND it, AND, and then 0, 0, 0, ta, 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 a lot of zeros, and only the last bit is 1. So that is masking out all the others, and then I will have as a final result either fully 0 or only 1 at the end. So I can do something like brands on equal or brands on not equal, whatever your algorithm, then the implementation of the algorithm is. But in case it is 1, we have to add the A operand to the result. So 0 plus 1, 0, 1, 0. That is still easy. 1, 0, 1, 0. So now my result is this, my new result. And now I'm going to shift A to the left and B to the right. So A is now 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, and B is now right shift. It drops off this one, and then the left we are filling it up with zeros. So what do we get here is 1. I don't know why it's doing a line here. Is 1, 0. I do again the masking B and 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. Well, that is just masking and only letting through this 0. So that actually in this case is 0. In this case, I have to do nothing. I don't have to do anything when this result is 0 at the end. So what I do, next step, I shift A to the left. A equals 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0. And I shift B to the right. So B is actually just 1. Doing again the masking, B and and then this pattern, whatever, how long, how many bits you have, I don't know, maybe 32, maybe 16, maybe 8, I don't know. But I will do the masking, and actually this mask with ending with B is actually 1, so I have to again add the result, add operand A to the result. The result until now was 1, 0, 1, and I have to add, let me see if I do this correct, I have to add this one, there goes my full adder, which I have already, the hardware which I have. Just do the plus, 0, 1, 0, 0, with a carry of 1, adding has carries, 1 plus 0. If there is nothing, of course, it's 0. This is implicit when I'm talking. 1 plus 0 plus 0 is 1, and then no carry, 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus 1 is actually 1. And as you can see, this is indeed, this is binary for 50 in decimal. So 10 times 5 is 50 in the decimal, and 1010 times 101 is 110010, which I can then at the end convert to decimal, and it's indeed 50. One of these axioms that I said in the beginning, that it doesn't matter which path you take, you can do first conversion, then multiplication, and then conversion back, or in any other number system, the result will always be the same. And this you can see now how this is done. This is indeed the case. So what we call this is the Russian peasant algorithm, which is shifting the operand A to the left and operand B to the right, and depending on the last bit of operand B, adding operand A to the result and continuing until our B value is completely zero, because now I can do again, could do this one to the left, and then A would be 1010000 and B would be zero. And I say like, okay, stop. Here, my calculation is ready. And I see the result is this one. So this is how the Russian peasant algorithm works for multiplication. In fact, we're not doing any multiplication at all. We're just doing shifting left, shift right, and checking the last bit. And if so, we're adding. So we could call this the shift mask add algorithm, but everybody calls this the Russian peasant algorithm. Okay, see you in the next lecture where I will explain divisions.